Hello. Hi, I'm Alex. I'm the CEO of Muse Robotics. We are enabling robot creators. Can you feel like this? No? After talking to. So the thing is that the last two years, we have been. Everyone is expecting the revolution in robotics. 2013 was named the year of the robots. It's expected to be an industry from 10 billion to 100 billion, but it's the reality of it is not getting there. Even if the you can see big companies investing in the space, like Amazon, well, with the delivering system and the pickup challenge, we have Google acquiring every robot company in 2013. Qualcomm just had an accelerator. We were one of the companies coming out of there. And Intel has a 21st century robot program. While we see consumer robots, robot companies getting there. The thing is that it's not advancing as fast as they expected. The main reason is that when you want to build a new robot, you have to start from scratch. And this is given by every CEO and CDO of large companies, they say that. Like Rethink has admitted that. I don't know, I don't remember who else, but like contract manufacturers are saying that. The result of starting from scratch is that you spend an enormous amount of time and money to get a robot to market. You also need a very important team, a very good team, that which huge deviation of what is needed. Like you need a firmware guy, you need an electronics guy, you need a mechanical designer, software designer, middleware designer, all these cost money. And of course, after you have built all that, you have just reinvented the wheel all over again. And you can now start focusing on your application after 1 or 2 years. So we see that there's a need for a hardware platform that is scalable and it can be used so that developers can build upon it. We have seen the same thing in the other industries. For example, WordPress has exploded because of this, because you can just download it and work on your website instead of starting an HTML program from scratch. The thing is that the existing solutions don't offer the complete package. So you can get bits and pieces from the industry. From industrial players, you can get a motor drive from here, a gearbox from there. You have to figure out how to interface them in a hardware manner. You have to figure out how to interface them in a firmware manner, and you lose like a huge amount of time doing that. These are barriers to market for smaller companies. So you have the big companies that already exist there. They already have the technology in-house. They keep it in-house, they use it to redesign their own robots, but if a new company wants to enter the market, it's practically has to have a very good application and to get some investment, even for getting into a prototype. So you need they need to assemble a team, which is not very easy because not that many people can do that. And their business plans involve years and millions. So it's very difficult to get investment. Well, I guess you or people know that say robot anatomy is very similar to human anatomy. You have the brain parts, you have the bones or the structure, the muscles and the nerves. On the brain side, we have seen great improvements, mainly because of the exponential increase in processing power nowadays. And the new consumer-grade sensors like structured light, Kinect, say new LiDAR light sensors, and of course you have the machine learning that companies are starting to get there. The structural part is different from robot to robot. For any custom robot, it's different, and depending on the application, it's the design changes. But nowadays, you can even 3D print that part if you don't need. High torques or high accuracy. The thing is that for the muscles and the nerves, for the solution that deliver the motion and the sensing, there's not a unified solution that delivers the electromechanical, the communications, the integration, and at the same time it's expandable and customizable. This is where we come in. So we offer a smart motor joints, a series of them. We offer a standard robot sensors, a power management platform, and at the same time we offer modules that you can customize. You have some user space that you can use to write your own program, interface your own sensors. At the same time, we are using ROS, so any sensor that's already compatible with ROS, you can use with our system. The result is that what we want to do, basically, is greatly reduce the time, money, and complexity related to building a robot and getting it to market. So our components are suitable for light industrial, biolab, and service robots, all of which have one thing in common. They work next to humans. This is the new trend of collaborative robots. To this end, our smart motor joints integrate force, power, and speed limitations to match the new safety standards. Well, our clients are small companies, startup with ideas that want to get to market, and they just want to focus on adding value to their system and not reinventing the wheel, basically. Eventually, we might want to engage contract manufacturers so they can use them in-house for their production lines, but this is far away for us still. So let's take a use case. This is Andrew. It was voted Product of the Year 2014. It's a robot that's doing pipetting for biolabs. The thing is that it took almost 2 years to build. And of course, this results in millions of the development costs. So let's say that the team wants to develop something similar, but this time with our components. They have the concept, the design, of course. But we will provide them the smart motor joints or the smart motor drives if they want to use their own motors. We will provide the sensors and the power management. We also provide some guidelines of how they can integrate in the system. So CAD files with the sensors they can use. They will be integrated in simulation programs like VREP as well. And then you can have a working prototype within weeks. This, getting started with, it can be 3D printed. And this is exactly what we have done just as a unit case. So while in the Qualcomm Robotics Accelerator, we built this for demo day. And it took 10 days. I will show you a video afterwards, how was the process. Everything is 3D printed, of course, but it's a prototype. The value of our system is that it's not only for prototyping. So it streamlines the entire process of getting a robot to market. It's an excellent prototyping tool, as you can just saw, but it is also suitable for integrating into each robot. The reason is that our modules will be pre-certified and they will be priced for integration. That, of course, is not going to be a small quantities, but at larger quantities, you will know that once you get to market, we will provide a price break would be very high reduction of cost. So this is the team. We are 4 founders and 2 engineers. We're all from Greece. Individually, I'm the CEO. I'm a mechanical engineer. And for some reason, I'm doing the electronic part. My CTO is a software guy. He's completing his PhD in the image processing. He's doing both firmware and software. We have a PhD and postdoc guy from EPFL. He has been designing robots for the last 8 years. And Yanis has a PhD in control systems, and he's also doing firmware and software. We have an early investor to help us with the business side because we're all engineers, of course. And as far as traction is concerned, validation, we have a project with ATH in Zurich. It's one of the leading robotics labs in the world. We made their motor drives to be integrated in their joints. They are using a series elastic actuators within their joints, and they are saying that our motor drives match the performance of existing players like Elmo. So this is what why we started at that, because it's the hardest part. So the motion control is the hardest part. Is not the any sensor or power management. That's much easier to achieve. So in the last 4 months, while in the accelerator, we have redesigned all the electronics to increase the performance. We have designed our custom gearbox. It's a planetary gearbox of a small gear ratio in order for the joints to be back drivable and safe. And we have integrated everything in a single package. This is actually a picture of our module. On the software side, we are now offering full motion control using any Ethernet-enabled device. We have used a standard PC, and we have used a Raspberry Pi 2 to do that. They are both running ROS, as I said, so anything that's compatible with ROS, it's working with our system. It's all Ethernet-based, and it's based on a single cable, both for power and communications. It's standard Ethernet for now. We might upgrade to EtherCAT. This is how the network is completed. So you can see the smart motors are a part of it, the smart motor joints. You can have standalone motor drives as well. You have the sensor modules and the power management modules, and everything couples up on Ethernet, and you have a API for us. So the next steps are getting early adopters by the end of the year, market validation, and we will be fundraising in January. This is a more detailed milestone. We plan to have a launch by 2017. In the meantime, we work with companies that are more of a generic application, which will be important for us to get the market's feedback of what is needed. Because at this point, we do have some specs in mind, but we can change them according to the needs and the cost versus performance, basically. Well, this is how the next generation of robots will be done. It's not like going to be like this. It's going to be with news. Thank you. Have any questions? The rough cost, if a company came to us, it would be about $6,000. Yeah, because each motor joint, the fully integrated, will be around $2,000, and then the motor drives are much cheaper, in the range of $300. And you have the stepper motors drives, which are about the same, and the stepper motors are cheap anyway. Less. Actually, I'll show you the video. So at the end of 10 days, you have a prototype that you can start working on the software side, basically, in the high level. And this was one guy. It's not the entire team. Any other questions? Okay, thank you.